door. Thanks for hospitality, George. Send a bill to Buckingham Palace.
Hey, help me. I guess it's on the go.
Oh? What do you want to go home for? The lawyer should be along in a few minutes. Sure to be good for half a crown for a barber at Butler.
Love that. Ha! That's a laugh. You ain't been here for months.
What's that got to do with it? What's half a crown after all I've given?
I won't you ever give her anything.
Anything? I gave her everything. I gave her the greatest gift that any human can give another. Life. I introduced her to this here paradise. This lovely world where the sunlit shines and the moon that glows. Hyde Park to walk around in a fine spring night. The whole ruddy city of London selling her blooming flowers. I give her all that. And you know, it disappears and leaves on her own to enjoy it. If that ain't worth half a crown now and again, I'll take my belt off and give her all.
Oh, Alfie, you got a good eye. But if you want that after Aunt Eliza, you better have good story to go with it.
Eliza, what's the prize?
Not a brass farthing.
Yeah, you wouldn't have the heart to send me back home to your stepmother without a bit of liquid protection.
Stepmother? Ha! Stepmother indeed.
I'm willing to marry her. It's me that suffers by it, Eliza. Just because I ain't an awful husband. Go on, Eliza. Sit your dead half a crown to go home on.
Well, I'd have had a lock myself tonight, boy.
Ha ha! George! Three glorious beers!
Don't keep coming around cutting on half crowns from me.
Thank you, Eliza. You're a noble's daughter. You see, boys, what I told you not to go home, it's just faith, hope, and a little bit of luck. The Lord above gave men a voice to do his job and have a show. The Lord above gave men a voice to do his job and have a show. A little bit of luck, a little bit of luck. Someone else will do the thinking. We've got to be neighbourly, my boys, after all. The Lord above made man.